You've made such intriguing design choices for the castle, my dear. They must be inspired.
Thank you, Vivian. I'm glad you approve.
When things have settled down a bit, I will take you to Valroyo and introduce you to my seamstress. And appearances are important. We can't have you mistaken for a commoner.
I suppose it's important to show that we're an authority to be respected.
Not just respected, my dear. Awed, feared, aspired to. You command an army of the faithful, outfitted by the coin of the nobility. You must be a man who the common folk aspire to be and to whom the nobility bow.
That's quite a lot for one person to pull off, don't you think?
It is a challenge all great leaders must face, Inquisitor. As the stories of the Inquisition spread, more and more people will wonder if you are the man they say you are. They will question what they've heard, but they will believe what they see. They must see someone greater than legends.
If that's your standard for me, what does the Divine have to live up to?
Andraste and the Maker cast very large shadows. The Divine absolutely must set the example for all Thedas. She must seem to be the embodiment of the Maker to the faithful. She needs the authority of the Maker and the charisma of Andraste. It will be no small task to fill that vacant throne. Did you need something, darling?
What are your thoughts about the others in the Inquisition?
What exactly is Varric's role in the Inquisition? Aside from irritating Cassandra.
Inquisitor.
The spiderwebs help stop the bleeding, and...
How's it going?
What did you want me to come see?
Here, come on. I'll show you.
Why am I dressed like this?
You'll see. Come on. It'll be worth your time, I promise. Evening. Iron Bull. My merc band just joined up.
Tanner. I'm from Jader. Well, Mir Jader.
Mira. I was guard captain for Lady Pendel. Signed on after shit blew up at the Conclave. Share a drink? Who's your friend?
This is Grim. He doesn't talk much.
They treating you all right out here?
Seem worse.
Hey, Grim. Do I know you from somewhere?
So, you ready to kill some demons? Or Venatori, or whatever that Corypheus asshole is?
This isn't just about killing. We're helping the Inquisitor save the world and build the next empire.
Well, long as I get paid, I'm happy. That's why I signed up.
I just couldn't spend my whole life on a farm. Needed to live a little, you know.
What about you, Mira? Why'd you join up? I thought you were serving some noble.
I saw what happened at Haven. The Inquisitor staring down that monster and his archdemon. I don't sing the chant of light as much as I should, but you can't see something like that and not believe.
Well, Grim and I should find our tents. Thanks for the drink. I know every soldier under my command. You don't have that option, but a few faces might help.
You made it sound like you didn't like the Inquisition.
People don't always tell the truth when you're polite. You've got to poke them a bit.
Those two soldiers might think you're an asshole.
So?
I knew some of the soldiers felt like that, but to actually hear it...
It's hard to be just an idea sometimes. That's all you are to most of them. It's why you could stand right in front of them without being recognized. You've got a good army coming along. Remember that, no matter what comes next.
Inquisitor. That's got a good ring to it. We're happy to be here, Your Worship. You need anything, let me know.
Can you think of any other tasks suitable for the charges?
I suspect Haven's quiet by now. Might be worth sending the boys back. We could recover some supplies, get an idea about the enemy's strength. We could even pick up any stragglers who haven't found Skyhold yet.
We'll talk later.
I hope I can help somehow. Maybe cleaning?
Oh, Inquisitor, I joined. Sutherland, Your Worship. I saw some bandits, so I came to warn people. I'll let your warriors know and then stay out of the way.
I'm telling you, I saw who I saw.
I'm pleased to hear it.
I was in Kirkwall. I know.
Hey, you. I have an Inquisitor favor to ask. Just a little thing, really. A little march around for some of your people. It's nothing for you, right?
All right. Let's hear what you've got.
Jump right in, huh? I like that. It's a Red Jenny thing. I got a tip that some noble stiffs are arguing over Vershel. Land squabble. They're getting little people beat up. So I need you to go to your big table and send some people to walk through town.
Just walk through.
Just walk through. Easy, right?
Was this a tip from one of your friends?
Not a Jenny. Just normal angry people getting sick of being in the middle. I don't usually hear about things this far away. But having a friend like you is like getting really big ears. Bigger ears, I guess. Shut up.
Who's asking for this?
I'm asking, because I heard people complaining. See, when nobles fight, it's not them, it's their little people stuck in the middle. It's like a polite war, so no one pays attention. But if you march through, the people up top feel threatened too. Stuff like this is always happening. Good sovereigns to be made if you're one of the few who notice.
What does the Inquisition get out of this?
Nobles think everyone is out to get them. So when your helmets march through, both sides will think the other's your ally. Both get scared, both make deals. Worst case, you get a little bump among the people just because they see you active. Can't promise anything, but something will happen. Just like always.
All right, Sarah. I'll have someone look into it.
It's fun, right? Being important without doing a thing. Well, not much of a thing. Not everything has to be torn skies and ancient assholes. Every little thing makes a difference somewhere. We're hiding.
What are you doing?
Listening. Eyes rough, jangling armor hurts my ears, back aching, fingers too clumsy for knots. Wind cool like Aunt Eloise's pond, lips scalded as I sip, warmth blossoms, first kiss in the barn, what was his name? Tin jangle as the blood spills, Pierre's wrapped body on the wagon to the chantry, 5 more minutes, my fault.
Can you listen to anyone's mind like you did hers?
No, they have to need me. Pain, fear, sadness, guilt, anger, hurt. Things I can fix.
Can you do something for her?
Yes. It's okay. Nothing you did mattered.
What? Who are you?
They lie there, and sometimes they die, just like Pierre. You can't save them.
I don't know who you are.
Wait. That didn't work. Let me try again. You'll forget me in a minute.
What are you going to do?
Make her forget me. Then do it again, the right way. You can't save all of them.
What?
Like Pierre getting sick after you snuck out to Aunt Eloise's pond. You want it to be your fault, so there's a reason and it's not so frightening. But there is no reason. Pierre just got sick. The soldier was never going to live. It wasn't your fault. Better.
She doesn't blame herself anymore.
Not as much. It was bouncing around inside her, closing up into a ball of wrong. Now it's open. She'll get it out.
Well done.
Thank you for letting me help her. It's not how a person would do it. But it helped. That's what matters.
This is just... it's something to keep their hands busy. I'm grateful you tracked me down when you did. As exciting as wandering the woodlands was, this is better. It's good to be part of something so important. Something that could change things.
The Grey Wardens are huge and important. You're part of that.
True, but without a blight on the horizon, everything the Wardens do feels like waiting. This, the Inquisition, is what matters now. And I'm grateful to be a part of it. You are who you choose to follow. Someone told me that once. Took me years to understand what he meant.
There's wisdom in that.
It was a Chevalier who said those words to me. A powerful man, but never without honor. A true knight. We met as competitors in the Grand Tourney. He left me with that advice before we parted. Put aside his own ambitions to help me win the melee. I don't think I even thanked him.
What is this Grand Tourney?
You've never heard of it. The Grand Tourney of the Free Marches. It's a spectacle. Song, dance, wine, every amusement you can imagine. But the greatest part is the contest of arms. Prove yourself in the Grand Tourney, and you can make your fortune.
How did he help you?
There were 100 men on the field, each one fighting for himself. The knight and I had forged an alliance. It was just the two of us, and we took all comers. The goal? Down as many opponents as possible. He always let me deliver the final blow.
That was generous of him.
He said I stood to gain everything, while he'd lose nothing. When it was over, he offered to mentor me. To teach me to become a chevalier like him. And I, young and stupid, turned him down flat. I just won the melee at the Grand Tourney. I didn't need him. I should have gone with him. Perhaps things could have been different.
Different doesn't always mean better.
In this case, I think it would have been better. But I'm older, hopefully wiser. And I think I've chosen the right person to walk with.
Your worship.
As leader of the Inquisition, you... There's something I must tell you.
You're being especially serious today.
I know. Lyrium grants Templars our abilities, but it controls us as well. Those cut off suffer. Some go mad, others die. We have secured a reliable source of Lyrium for the Templars here. But I no longer take it.
You stopped?
When I joined the Inquisition. It's been months now.
Cullen, if this can kill you...
It hasn't yet. After what happened in Kirkwall, I couldn't. I will not be bound to the Order or that life any longer. Whatever the suffering, I accept it. But I would not put the Inquisition at risk. I've asked Cassandra to watch me. If my ability to lead is compromised, I will be relieved from duty.
Are you in pain?
I can endure it.
Cassandra takes things as seriously as you do. If she has no problem with this, neither do I.
I thought you had a right to know. The Inquisition's army must always take priority. Should anything happen, I will defer to Cassandra's judgment.
Good book?
Ah! I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, because I suddenly went blind.
Oh, that. Just reports from Commander Cullen.
You're an excellent liar.
It's of no interest to you, I'm certain. It's a book.
I can see that.
It's... one of Varric's tales, Swords and Shields, the latest chapter.
So you like to read? What's wrong with that?
It's frivolous. There are more important things for me to do.
She's read this one 3 times.
You! I told you to stop spying!
You read it out loud to me. I don't like the captain either.
I never did that! It's literature. Smutty literature. Whatever you do, don't tell Varric.
Maybe I should read that book.
You? No!
Why not me?
You're the Inquisitor.
Oh, I see.
They're terrible. And magnificent. And this one ends in a cliffhanger. I know Varric is working on the next. He must be... You could ask him to finish it. Command him to... Pretend you don't know this about me.
Inquisitor.
Is this a bad time? I can come back.
No, it's all right. Bills are really not that engrossing. I've been meaning to come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
I don't need a disciple. I need a friend.
If you knew how intimidating you are, you wouldn't make it sound so simple. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
What am I to you, then?
A None of this shit makes any sense to me. Is this the end of the world? Did Andraste send you through the breach? I have no idea. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Please tell me you aren't going to burst into song now.
Don't worry, I'm not that cruel. I should probably get back to work. Unless, you up for a game of Wicked Grace? I've got a minute if you need something.
Cassandra is waiting for the next issue of Swords and Shields.
I must have heard that wrong. It sounded like you just said that Cassandra read my books.
She's a pretty big fan, in fact.
Are we talking about the same Cassandra? Tall, grumpy seeker, likes stabbing things? Wait, did you say the romance serial? Oh, she'll be waiting for a while then. I haven't finished it and wasn't planning to. That book is easily the worst I've ever written. The last issue barely sold enough to pay for the ink.
Well, Cassandra seems to be hooked on it.
And I honestly thought a hole in the sky was the weirdest thing that could happen. So, you want me to finish writing the latest issue of my worst serial for Cassandra? Oh, that's such a terrible idea. I have to do it. On one condition. I get to be there when you give her the book.
You've got a deal.
I'll get to work then. You know, the fact that the book is terrible just makes it more worthwhile somehow.
What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
Oh, yes. Do you really think I'd miss this?
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was falsely accused.
Well, it turns out the guardsman...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
This was everything I'd hoped.
I know how you feel.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it.